Okay. I had someone earlier today, actually, it was Will in China, said how he hates email. And I guess I've grown to love email because really I have no choice. It kind of governs my day. It's almost my to-do list. And some people may say that's not the most efficient way to work, but as things come in, as tasks come into email, I can kind of prioritize what it is I need to do for a given day or task. And so Gmail is something that I think most of us should have a Gmail account. If you're on Google Plus, if you're a YouTuber, you probably have Gmail. And I think that's what made me find eventually sign up for a Gmail account was when I started doing YouTube videos. I realized I needed a Gmail account. And hence, because I love Chrome and I love experimenting with different extensions, feel free to jump in, anybody. And I love experimenting with different Chrome extensions. I've ran across a couple that work really well with Gmail that I want to talk to you guys about and I want to share with you. Now, you may know that I have a very popular blog called Basic Blog Tips. And on Basic Blog Tips, thanks for the props, I have guest bloggers. And a lot of times people will just contact me out of the blue and they will, want to guest post. They'll pitch me a guest post, which is perfectly fine. But over time, I realized that I needed to have a vetting process for these guys so that I wouldn't just let any old, Tom Schmo up on my blog. Okay. So I found a couple of tools that will help me with the vetting process of these folks who contact me. Of course, when I want to, or one of my friends contacts me, I don't really have to go through this vetting process. I already know them, I already know their work. I know how they are with responding to comments and that they're not plagiarizing material and all that. One that I want to talk about is called full contact. And this tool is really important, guys, for me, as I said, in the vetting process of guest authors. And I also get a lot of emails from folks who want me to test out their products. Okay. And so what this helps me do, and I'm actually over in my email right now. Okay, this one is from a guy named James. All right, doesn't know me. I have no idea who he is. And he says, I'm working with a number one SSL certificate reseller provider. And I won't say the name of the provider because I don't even know if this guy's for real. I was browsing your blog and I really like the blogs you've posted. I'm interested to provide an article as a guest post. Here I am attaching one article written by me. I hope you would like to publish on your blog. Thanks. Huh? Wait, dude, I don't know you, boo. So what I can do with full contact will show me. Now, of course, it's only going to work based on the email address that he used to send this email. It will show me if it's his Facebook, his LinkedIn, his Twitter, his Klout, and if he is using his email for Twitter, it'll show me his last few tweets. I mean, it will give me so much information. It'll give me his About Me page, all of his websites that he's using that email for. It'll tell me his gender. I can't, if this was someone that I was really interested in, I could quickly click on a link to set up a Google Hangout with him or put him on my calendar or add him to my contacts. I can add tags that he, or notes that he would not see. So, and put him in groups and all that. So for a free tool, I think it's just absolutely amazing. Yes. And Leon, I didn't delete this email only because I wanted to save it as an example of how not to contact an influencer when you want a blog post. I mean, this guy is sending me a blog post. I have no idea who he is. And in fact, in the full contact, this particular person, the only thing they have connected to this email is a Facebook page. So I can't even do my real recon that I would do, not with full contact. But yet, there is another tool that I have that I could do a little more research on this particular chap. And it's called Discoverly. Ha ha. I'm sneaky. I know. I'm very sneaky. People use different emails for different jobs, though, so don't judge too harshly. Love Discoverly. I know. This is why I use more than one tool, so that I can not only, like I said, in full contact, it only showed me Facebook. So I clicked on that Facebook link, and that's when Discoverly kicks in, which I can just hover over and Discoverly. I have a video that shows how this works. Discoverly will put a little icon right next to the person's profile image, and it will let you know if they're on LinkedIn. Now, that didn't come up in full contact. I'm not sure why, but it did in Discoverly. It tells me that I have one connection in common with this guy, and if I want to, I can go onto his LinkedIn profile and find out more. Then I can also see the mutual friends that we have over on LinkedIn, which in this case, I'm not going to do that because I already rejected this guy's guest post and already told him, no thanks. I'm not interested in you. Okay. All right. So let me give you an example of something that was good. I already knew this particular fellow. He started working for one of my friends who has this new tool called Ninja Outreach. The thing about Ninja Outreach, if anybody's interested in that tool, just let me know. But personally, I don't need Ninja Outreach because I'm pretty much well connected with a lot of influencers. And believe it or not, Blab is my Ninja Outreach. I have connected with just about every social media mogul that I wanted to connect with right here on Blab. In fact, I can't think of anybody that's missing. So, but for those of you who are don't have that many connections, you want to reach out with to influencers, you want to try to connect with folks and build up those relationships, you might want to check out a tool called Ninja Outreach, but it is a paid tool. I'm not an affiliate because, like I said, I don't even use it because I don't even need it. But anyway, I got an email from this fella who was working for the guy who I already know about who uses the tool. So he's like, I was wondering if you'd be interested in joining our affiliate program since you've already worked with us in the past. When we wrote this post for you, and he links to a Triber post that was a guest post on my blog from the fellow who created this tool. Thanks for the opportunity. You can become an affiliate here. We offer 50% recurring commissions. And I thought this was a nice email. You know, this is the kind of person that you want to hear from. They're saying, hey, you can make some money promoting our tool. But I didn't join. I just told you guys I'm not an affiliate because I don't promote tools that I don't use. But I will recommend you guys to check it out. So on this one, in full contact, I can see Facebook, Twitter, Klout, two different websites. One is the Ninja Outreach. One is the Ninja Outreach blog. I can see another social site that I'm not familiar with. I can see Pinterest. I see his Gravatar profile. So now I'm going to click on Facebook because remember I told you Discoverly is the second part of my process here. So now here I can see the LinkedIn. I can see the mutual connections that we have over on Facebook. Got 23 of them. And what is this one? Angel List. Okay. The Angel List is the other one that I couldn't recognize earlier. I don't use it, but I'm sure folks who are doing startup work use it. I can click on his recent tweets also here in Discoverly. So those are a couple of tools, guys, that I wanted to share with you. It is amazing. And it's amazing that these tools are free. And so that's why I know about these extensions for Gmail, which was the topic of today.